Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, you're joining us on Football Sri Lanka TV. We are here for another episode of The Life with Football. Recently, the talk of the town with the Sri Lankan football community has, of course, been all the Sri Lankans playing in foreign leagues. But one specific name has been very unjustly left out in all those conversations. And he is my guest here today. That man is, of course, the young player at the age of 18, plays for a very historic club in England, Queen's Park Rangers, QPR, who currently play in the English second division, which is the championship. Dylan De Silva, welcome Dylan, thank you for joining us today.
Thank you.
Dylan, just to kick us off a little, as I said, all the Sri Lankans recently in the football community have been talking about all the Sri Lankans playing abroad. So, as I said, your name has been one that most people for now don't know about, but in the future, I'm sure we'll all be talking about you. So, can you just give us a little introduction about yourself? Tell us, who is Dylan De Silva?
I'm Dylan De Silva. I'm 18 and I'm the eldest son of my family and I have two younger brothers. And I completed my education at Trinity Catholic High School. And right now, I'm a professional football player at QPR. Been playing football now for around 10 years. And at the highest level, obviously, I played for Tottenham. And then I've been at loads of different clubs around the country, like the likes of West Ham, Arsenal, and stuff like that. And I was approached by Amir Alagic a few months ago. And we had a good chat about, you know, me getting involved with the Sri Lankan national team. And later on, Asif, the manager, got in touch with my dad. And a funny story about that is that Asif and my dad were classmates at Wesley College back in the day in Colombo. So that was quite good to know. And following a Zoom call me and my parents had with the president, Anura De Silva, I am really looking forward to representing Sri Lanka in the professional level. And yeah. I should mention that Asif has been really helpful, you know, coordinating everything to date and giving consideration to the different time zones and schedules. And yeah, I look forward to working with everyone there during the international break.
Definitely. Next, can you tell us, like, so going back to your past a little bit, what exactly got you into the sport of football? What made you a football fan? What made you fall in love with the game?
For me, it started at a young age, but obviously as my parents are Sri Lankan, my dad introduced me to cricket at the start and I followed and played cricket as a younger kid, but I wasn't too good at cricket and my dad kind of realised that. But even my uncle, he's quite a well-known cricketer as well.
And when you played, did you used to be a bowler, batsman, all-rounder?
I was a fast bowler. I was good, but I kept bowling the ball too high and it just went over the guy's head. So I wasn't too good at that, to be honest. But yeah, my uncle, Daminda Wijesekera, he played cricket for Sri Lankan level and stuff like that, and he was really good. So I looked up to him, but it didn't really work out for me. And anyway, when I became 7 years old, my friends were playing football after school, and I just thought, you know, it looks fun, why not just give it a go? And from that moment onwards, I just knew it was for me. Like, I just fell in love with the game there, really, and from then, went on to bigger things, to be fair. And yeah, that's where I am today.
Definitely. And then, so as I mentioned earlier, you play in a very historic club currently. QE Queen's Park Rangers is currently in the second division in the championship. And they are a club that have been in the Premier League many occasions. And stadium as well, Loftus Road, I believe, is a club that has featured in the Premier League. And you have played in that stadium. So what has been the feeling playing in a stadium that has a Premier League level stadium? What was the feeling?
It's a huge privilege playing for QPR and, you know, in the stadium, the atmosphere is amazing. Like, it's very, like, the fans are so close to you. You just feel like their presence, you know what I mean? And the first time I played there was when I was 16. It was in the FA Youth Cup and there was a few fans there. And it's just like, when I stepped onto the pitch, I just felt the energy and the love of the fans. And it just made me really feel, you know, this is where I want to be, playing in stadiums in front of fans. And yeah.
Definitely. And then, just also to elaborate on that, before you joined QPR, You yeah. used to be in the Tottenham Hotspur Academy. You used to be in some other big clubs as well. What was the decision you took, the thinking process behind joining QPR from such academies?
For me, Tottenham was a great experience, you know, top level academy. But in my head, I thought the right move for me, if I want to, because obviously I'm 18 now, I'm in the first team at QPR. And I feel like if I was still at Tottenham, it would have been a longer process, obviously, because it's a bigger club. So I thought the right move for me would be to move on to not a smaller club, but just like, if you know what I mean, like Tottenham's quite a big club, it's harder. And I just thought it was the right move for me at the time. Get more football, get more minutes. And yeah, I think it paid off now with the first team.
Help develop your career. QPR is a big club as well when you look at their history.
Of course, yeah, of course.
And then also, I've heard that you're in on the football pitch. One of your best qualities is in one-on-one situations. Can you tell us a little bit more about that? Have you specially trained for those type of situations? How did that come about?
For me personally, I've always been a player to enjoy a battle. So when I get the ball and there's players around me, it's not even just one versus one. It could be one versus four or five. I just enjoy having players around me that I can just beat. And I've always been the player to just get past all of them and then cross it or shoot. And yeah, just I enjoy that battle. I enjoy that battle with players, defenders near me. And I beat them most of the time. So yeah.
So you enjoy dribbling past defenders, dribbling around the goalkeeper?
Exactly. Yeah.
That's kind of it. Then growing up, like you said, you started with cricket, but then moved to football. Were there any, do you have any footballing idols who you looked up to, who you thought, okay, I want to end up playing like them one day?
For me, when I was younger, it's always been Cristiano Ronaldo, just his whole mentality, like his mentality from young, you know, growing up, starting at the bottom, going all the way to the top. And I just feel like I just want to follow that pathway, you know, his everything about him, you know, the way he plays, the way he is off the pitch, his diet, his, you know, his health and everything. And also recently, Mbappe, I don't know, Kylian Mbappe, he's a young French player. And since he's come on the scene, I've really just loved the way he plays. You know, he's young and I just feel like that can be me in a couple of years' time, hopefully.
Definitely, why not? Because he also came out of nowhere, basically.
Exactly. Yeah.
Like you said, Ronaldo, Mbappe, they all have their strict diets they follow. Do you also follow a strict diet?
Yeah, it's very strict, man. It's hard. When I was younger, it was hard to follow it, but starting to grow into it more and I understand how much it helps. Like, you wouldn't know, like, it's helped so much.
I mean, you learn that it's worth the effort, worth the energy.
Definitely, yeah.
So then, moving on. So, coming back to Sri Lanka for a little bit. So, tell us about your ambitions to play for Sri Lanka. Like, was that always something in the back of your mind that, okay, I want to represent Sri Lanka one day, or now since you're in England, what was the thought process behind? Did you ever have that in the back of your head?
For me, it's always been there, but it's definitely been in the back of my parents' head, obviously, because they were born in Sri Lanka and I was born in England and lived there all my life. But knowing that my parents grew up there, you know, Sri Lanka's my second home. So for me, when I was presented with this opportunity to play in such a beautiful country, you know, I can't turn that down. And, you know, I'm happy and really looking forward to it. So, yeah.
Have you visited Sri Lanka in the past? Have you traveled around?
Yeah, traveled a lot, like, this is my go-to country. If I want to go on holiday, I always say Sri Lanka, because the food, I love the food, love everything. I love everything about it, the beaches. It's a beautiful country.
Now that you've gotten the chance to represent your country, your parents must be very happy since... Yeah.
They're so proud and it makes me happy to put a smile on their face, you know, like that. So,
definitely. So now, as we said, you are currently in the QPR main team. You train with the first team, you play with them. So, a player of your stature, you are a professional player, really. And that is what we really need in the current situation in Sri Lanka. Yeah. What do you think with your experience training with such big professional clubs, playing and training with such professional players, what do you think you can bring to football in Sri Lanka?
I think I can bring just the experiences I've had, like playing for all the different clubs in the country. Obviously, Sri Lanka... it's still growing in the football term. So I think I can just bring a bit, you know, like just the whole discipline, you know, just how to train, make sure you're every day you have to work hard, you know what I mean? Like, if you really want to succeed in football, every day, you can't have no days off. It's every day you got to be working. I just feel like I can bring that kind of mindset and maybe even help the other players to develop further by just talking to them and just saying, you know, if you like, you must have talent. If you're playing for Sri Lanka, you must have talent. But maybe just that little mindset that you might just have to improve. And then, yeah, I think it'd be good.
Definitely. And then moving on to another moment in your career so far, can you tell us one of your proudest or most favourite moments in your football career so far?
Wow, there's quite a few. If I said my proudest to date, probably being called up to the first team. So obviously I'm only 18, but being called up to the first team at the age of 18 was, you know, that's a dream come true. That's what you want as a youngster. Because other players maybe break through at 20, 21. But for me to get that at such a young age, I'd say was definitely a really proud moment, not just for me, but for my family. And I feel like
it's such a big club like QPR in the championship.
Exactly. And I wasn't really, not that I wasn't expecting it, but I was being realistic. I thought I'm only 18, you know, I'd probably have to wait a couple of years. But, you know, when it came, yeah, it was amazing, amazing feeling.
Definitely. And so now, like I said, you mentioned that you are still studying and stuff. You are 18, you play for a professional club, you are a professional player in the first team. But you still haven't stopped studying, have you? Like, I've heard that you are still going to university, still...
Yeah. For me, like, my mom's always spoken about the value of education. And I've always also had in the back of my mind, you know, like, I want to get a degree. Like, I want to be a footballer, don't get me wrong, but I still want to have that as well. I've always just wanted to do it. And luckily, my parents have always been supporting me with my passion for football. But they've also supported me very highly with education. So when I had to leave high school to play football full-time for QPR, I did a qualification. It's equivalent to A-levels, the three A-levels. So it was on the side. And in that 2 years that we did that, I got distinctions. So that's basically like equivalent of three A-stars. So from that and my good GCSEs that I got, I got a place, I got an offer to place in a university in London, and I will eventually do that. I deferred it a few years because I want to focus on football right now. But eventually, I'm going to want to do that and get a degree. And it's, yeah, I just feel like it's good, like, not always, like, I don't even look at it as a B plan. I look at it more like when I retire, because football is not really a long sport. Like, it's not a long career. When I retire, I want to have something to do, you know what I mean?
So you're not thinking of going into managerial?
That's obviously there as well. But, you know, why not try other things as well? See what you enjoy. You never know.
Exactly. That's a very good philosophy to look at it. Yeah. And then moving on to the same topic, basically, you're still 18, like you said, a young player, despite being in the first team. But you also, while playing and developing your own career, you also mentor young Asian players, don't you? Like you, can you tell us a little bit about that? Because it's impressive for a young player like you, despite still developing home career, you're at the same time trying to bring other players up with you. And just tell us a little bit about that.
I think for me, the reason I got involved in this is because growing up as a youngster, a young Asian footballer, I don't really have too many Asian role models, if you know what I mean. There's not many Asian players that have broken through in the Premier League, etc. And I just thought, like, that's not right, you know what I mean? It should be the same Asian, you know, whatever country from, it shouldn't matter. So for me, I got involved just to kind of show the younger kids, the younger Asian kids, and even the parents that it is possible, you know what I mean? If you put your mind to it, it is possible. There's going to be so many setbacks. Like, I've been through so many setbacks, rejections, loads of injuries, but I just kind of just talk to the younger ones and just say, you know, you got to get through them. You can't give up because of one setback. You know what I mean? Maybe you get released from a club. Maybe you have an injury. You have to keep going. And I just told the parents as well, like, obviously, as a youngster, you want your kids to do well in education, but there's nothing wrong with letting them play football on a Sunday at the start. You know what I mean? Just to see if they love the game. And yeah, I just talked to them. And I even talked to older pros as well, like people older than me, to kind of get advice from them as well. And it's just a good system, definitely, just to kind of try and get more Asian footballers into the football scene.
That's beautiful, because I mean, that's already at the age of 18, you're basically a role model for kids coming up. That's a football attitude to have for any player at any age, really. So, a few final stuff. Are you excited to be a part of the Sri Lankan national team?
Can't wait. It's an amazing feeling to represent the country, such a beautiful country as well. And yeah, hopefully I can bring Sri Lanka football to the next level.
Fans will be hoping for that as well. Before we go, can you tell us a few other passions you have as well? Often I've heard that you're an F1 fanatic as well.
Obviously I love F1, I love Lewis Hamilton, just that whole, I don't know what it is about it, just I'm so interested in F1. Not that I would never be an F1 driver, because I wouldn't be too good at that, but yeah, I love watching F1. I love watching a lot of sports, tennis, table tennis, you know, and I play loads of different sports as well in my spare time, so yeah, I just love sports in general, really.
That's great. And then one final thing, for all our Sri Lankan fans watching or eagerly waiting to see you in action, do you have a message for them?
Sri Lanka sports welter Dakshara Dak, ek approved Kerala Tiano cricket willing, eating Ogolo believe Karot, Saha support Karot, Ogolange football welter, Tika Kaling, Sri Lanka football welter, Honda Tenak, Gandapula. Mama Godak Kamati journey support Karanda to the best of my ability for Sri Lanka football. Welter Jaya Ganda. So let's do this, guys.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, thank you for joining us for today's episode of Life with Football with our very special guest from all the way from London, England, Dylan De Silva. Even though he's in London, he is our very own Sri Lankan local boy. He will be joining our national team very soon. And I'm sure fans are very excited to see a player of your professional level playing for our country as well. Thank you for joining us, Dylan. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Stay tuned to Football Sri Lanka TV. Subscribe and stay tuned for more content. Thank you.
Thank you.